Hello and welcome to Open Door. I think I got this right. Jeez. This is David Brockway, and I want to kind of continue on the love and relationships right now. You know, because if I voice my opinion about stuff, and even if I feel I know things that you don't know, after people out there don't want to hear somebody else's opinion. Love and relationships, for some reason, ties in with self-love. You know, we all can relate to that. We all want to know, even if we're happily married, for some reason, I don't know what it is. Especially, you know, for the female gender. And so, and I'm doing this because I was watching, Showtime has a, every season they have a thing on couples counseling. And I was watching it, and it reminded me of what I've done in the past. And so I wanted to just bring some more issues that some people might be able to relate. So let's go at it. A big thing in therapy is psychoanalyzing the person from childhood, because all those things kind of affect a lot of people. And you'd be surprised how many people have really had a tough life, but they're not out whining about it or anything. There's so many things about us in psychology that we want to be, sometimes we complain a lot or whine because we're getting attention or something like that. We need attention or something. So I want to talk about some conflicts that people have in relationships. And one of the big ones is sex. So many times, especially a woman, will have issues of not wanting, just can't get into it. And by far, that's a psychological problem that's within the girl. Because men, you know, no matter what our problems are, we still probably will pretty much want to have sex all the time. Okay, not quite like that. But when it comes to a relationship, it's really important. Forget about this woke thing where everybody whines, the trans people. Boy, they're the biggest whiners there is. Look it, step up to the plate, you know, take it like a human being, you know, stop whining about stuff. And if you have a partner, both parties got to work in all different directions all the time. It's not easy. There's, the 50-50 thing is a total joke. The 50-50 thing in a relationship reminds me of the Black Lives Matter movement. It is just so, just tossed out, and it's based on the id. Me, I, and myself. People wanting more, more, more. Look it. Before, I had said, just find yourself a nice person and learn to be nice yourself. And this is a good way to a relationship. If you have a partner, whether it's a boyfriend, a girlfriend, a husband, or wife, friends with benefits, well, that wouldn't really work in a relationship. It's not really much of a relationship. But it's important that both parties understand, but you have to provide a form of satisfaction. You need to satisfy your partner one way or the other. Now, if it's a man and they want to have sex, then you need to somehow learn to please them, even if you're not in the mood. Because there's not going to be a relationship. That partner is going to end up probably having an affair on you. Because there's always outside forces coming in. In a relationship, of course, unless you live in the woods somewhere and there's nobody miles and miles, you don't see a human being for like weeks on end and stuff. But you know, we all have stress and everything in our daily lives, and we have to learn to compromise and negotiate. Negotiation is everything in a relationship. So you have to make it work. And you can go see a therapist. You know, the problem I have with a lot of therapists, half of them aren't even any good. And the biggest problem, the hardest thing a therapist has to do is to keep that patient. So they want to keep you for 6 months, a year, 5 years, 10 years. Hey, 6 months from now, I don't want to look at your faces. If I can't, you know, if I'm still looking at you 6 months, I couldn't do anything. I couldn't help you. You need to go onward. Okay, but they don't care. They collect, the insurance companies run mental health now, and they control everything, and people just get paid and paid and paid. Even if you cancel, they're getting paid, the therapist. It's all about money. There's no ethics anymore. We're getting worse and worse as a nation, as a species. The more supposedly enlightened we get, the more selfish we get, the more controllable. If we're controlled, we need to control something. We need to change that makes our life look better because we deserve it. I'm a human being. I'm a person. I'm a he and a she. I am one. I deserve the best. Let me tell you something. Wake up and throw away that mirror because you're seeing something that the world isn't seeing, and it's just not that way. Yeah, it can't be that way. In a relationship, it's negotiating. It's partnership. You are planning things, working things together, but you're helping each other and pleasing each other. If you're not in the mood and it's been 2 weeks, what's going on? I mean, if you're in your 80s, okay. But if you're in your 30s, if you're in your 40s, your 50s and 60s, 2 weeks and the man wants more sex, because men do have a libido, as it be a little more progressive than a woman does, you know, you need to, like, you know, step up to the plate and take care of your man, and your man needs to take care of his woman. And that's just it. If you're very woke, that can entitle so many different aspects. It'd be enough to make it go crazy. Basic thing, a man's a man, a woman's a woman. We've been knowing how that works for years. No matter how we go, I don't know, you know, we joke around, I'll even put up clips about all that stuff. But, you know, the reality is, look, men are not dumb. The weight of a man's heart is not through his stomach. And you can be gorgeous looking and great in bed, but then after a while, that's going to fade. You know, there's that, I don't want to call it chemistry, because chemistry is more of an infatuation. It's just where two people truly love each other and they work together. If they don't, you need to go onward. You need to leave. I know if you have children, you don't want to do that. And you can say, oh, I'm going to wait till they're grown. And, you know, then that never happens. Look, it. In this day and age, being divorced, being brought up in a divorce, isn't a big thing nowadays. But it's always good to wait till the kids are grown. And after they're grown, then, you know, and maybe on, you know, they'll go on their own, whether they go to college or wherever, you need to, like, leave, get out. Go to another, find another relationship. Find something that's good for you. Two people need to be happy most of the time. If you have a trauma in your life, okay, that's where you really need counseling, okay? If there's a death of somebody close by, family, or accidents and things like that, there's a lot of, you know, you really need help. But as for the relationship between the two people, you need to always negotiate and work together and help and please your partner. Do for them what you would want done for you all the time. You can't do it all the time, and I'm sorry that I just said that. You have to do it in a acceptable amount of time. You have to help them. Hugs, kisses, every single day. You don't show that love and attention to your mate, he or she is gonna, like, get a little depressed and that could just linger on, and then they'll do little digs to get back at you. Not worth it. If you don't love your mate, whether you got kids or not, get out. Get out. You should not be in a toxic relationship, and that's what it's all based on. You should not be in a toxic relationship, and all therapy, psychology wants you to stay in a relationship. They want to do whatever they can to help that relationship and let it drag on, because that's money in their pocket. Toxic relationship is the worst thing to be in. I don't care if you got 300 children. Get out of there. Get out of any toxic relationship. If it's not toxic and it's very good, then figure it out and get on. Give, give, give. Both parties. One gives and the other one doesn't give, out. You know, you got to get out. You got to separate, let them think, and then you go back and it's the same thing, you leave. You don't give them three. This isn't a freaking baseball game where they got three strikes, because that three turns into four, you know, five. No. Doesn't work. They keep hitting a foul ball. I have to keep taking them back. No, no, no. You know how many people have gotten married to the same woman 3-4 times? I mean, you know, I say, how stupid is that? You know, it didn't work out the first time. It could possibly work out the second time, but never the third, fourth, or fifth, or sixth, or whatever. And the same thing in a relationship of a boyfriend and girlfriends. Well, we were young, Mel, you know, we're older now. Yeah, maybe, sure. But, you know, don't linger on to old stuff. Go on to new things. All right, until then, I bet you I went over. I'll see you real soon.